Yes.
The lineal shape of the two Fokker triplanes at the back. And Bruce Dickinson, you'll see the two aircraft both have snake stripes just behind the crosses on the fuselage. And Bruce is flying the one with the black and white stripes. And the second of the two triplanes there with the red and white markers is being flown by Peter Bond from Norwich. Being bounced by one of the two Junkers CL1s, got on the tail of the Sopwith triplane, coming into the crowd left. We've got a bit of smoke from the Sopwith. Meanwhile, another Junkers. And a classic train of aircraft now heading out over to the right side as again leaving smoke, one of the Junkers CL1s get backed by the US Air Service. Well, how about that for a takeoff? But watch this next manoeuvre. It's not the sort of manoeuvre you do with Granny down the back with a gin and tonic in her hands. She would complain. What a fantastic, to be so close to that large aircraft on takeoff, that's something unique with the theatre that we have here at Farnborough. Engineering project began in June 1994 when the type referred to as the 3XX. Official go-ahead was in December 99, and when an order for the 50th aircraft came in December the next year, the industry launch was confirmed. The maiden flight of the A380 occurred in January 2005, lasting some 3 hours and 54 minutes. It was the start of a test program incorporating some 2,200 flying hours and lasting some 15 months. Rolls-Royce engines of this, the Rolls-Royce Trent 900, 70,000 pounds plus. Put that into something else in the other context. The Trent 900 draws in enough air to inflate 72,000 party balloons in 1 second. And the success of the A380 can be seen that in January this year, orders stood at over 300 orders, 304 to be exact, with 122 of these aircraft types already delivered. Departure, change of direction, a tactical departure. You don't want to hang around with small arms fire, that sort of thing, in a war zone. So this is wrong. I'm sure that every TV in there has this feature. I wouldn't have a clue how to work it, but ask a teenager and they would help you out. Typhoon is Mark 2, and at low level the aircraft can accelerate from 200 knots to Mark 1 in just 30 seconds. Here is the Harrier. Making the Harrier on for Saturday and Sunday as well. Fast run from the left. That classic whistle of the Pegasus engine, signature of the Harrier jets.
Second later, Reds 4 and 5, and 2.5 seconds behind them, Reds 6, 7, 8, and 9. Give them a big wave as they run past you on the runway. Royal Air Force's purpose today is twofold. It's to protect the nation and its interests 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. And it's also to provide the nation with choices during times of crisis. 4G, Red 1 now calls them into short diamond formation where you'll see the aircraft collapse to around 6 to 8 feet away from each other. They reach 6,000 feet or a mile above us at the top of this loop. Red 1 at the front there is squadron leader Jim Turner. It's his third and final year as the team's leader. He is a former Jaguar pilot by trade, but he's very experienced in the display world, having displayed the Jaguar. Spent 3 years previously with the Red Arrows, including leading the synchro pair. But recently, he has spent 3 years as the official advisor for the Royal.
From the front left, the NATO code word for the Su-27 is flanker.
Thank you.
twisting this loop towards us through 90 degrees in a quarter clover. Now get your cameras ready. This is the vertical break. Rolls to the outside of the formation in the rollbacks. This is the mirror pass. Now give the synchro pair a wave as they fly past, upside down, boys and girls. Busy with the red smoke is Red 5 Flight Lieutenant Steve Morris. Steve's second year with the team. He's a former Hawk instructor. Operationally, he's flown both the Harrier GR9 and the Tornado GR4 before donning his red suit last year.
Solutions can be also used in law enforcement, security, modern.